caught up on this flow. Wind up on it, rubbing through my head, From the front, back, side, girl, I love it. Tonight I might just wheel. Cut the radio on, I'm bumping that Johnny Gill. She said, Michael, you nasty. I said, no, I'm just real. She started playing her role. This DJ got too real. I off my dreads, then fell off. She slowed me down, then sat me down, then started.
Oh my God.
Now personally, I don't know this, but I'm digging all her ways. She 5'2 and I'm 6'4, I'm going in MJ. From the front, back, side, girl, I love the way you do. Hello, everybody, and welcome to The Cutting Edge.
Hello, we do that.
You do. I love it, too. Hello, everybody, and welcome to the season finale of season 4 of The Cutting Edge. How you guys feeling tonight?
Feeling good.
Another season finale, and once again, we are live right here on Comcast 95, Verizon 36. So, how's everybody week been?
It's been good.
It's been good.
Not as busy, but it's been good. Yeah, how's your week been?
Oh, my week has been busy. Weeks are always busy. So
always.
I really don't complain about that.
I did. I complained today. I need a day where I just don't do nothing. I don't want to call. Be tired, man.
I know, but you know what?
The choices you make. You got to deal with your lifestyle.
Yep. And it's called being a business owner and not just someone in business.
Employee. Yes. Where you can call out sick, somebody feels in your spot, you know. You are the spot. You're wearing the boots.
Right. Hope y'all doing good all day on this good Thursday. The weather been kind of crazy, right?
Yeah, the weather.
It feel good,
you know what? A few weeks ago we spoke about this whole weather thing.
Yeah.
The weather was actually feeling kind of good, and then it got kind of cold. For 1 week we was here and it was cold.
Mm-hmm.
And then we kind of came back into, well, you got your sweatshirt on, so I know you was feeling a little breezy
tonight. But earlier,
it was really good.
It get cold. Yeah. It get cold at night, probably like after like 5:36 when you get
cold.
Like off, right. Whatever, it be cool outside. But
yes. Ladies and gentlemen, we just want to say once again we are at a season finale, and I am really not ready to go.
I'm not ready to go. We're coming right back.
You can check us out January. I definitely will give you guys the dates. Don't forget to like our page on Facebook. That's RVA's The Cutting Edge. Whatever you do, you want to like that page because you want to keep up with everything that's going on. The co-hosts, you know, you can talk to them on the page. You can actually reach out to them on their Facebooks, on their Twitters, on their Instagrams. We give you our information here weekly, so it's no reason why you shouldn't be able to contact us.
Now, got a strange contact on Facebook.
Okay. Strange contact. Oh, man.
It was weird.
My goodness.
I know we tell people to hit us up and say this and say, you know. But no strange contact.
So we don't.
But I think this is a fake person. I even like went to that page, right?
Catfish.
They wrote in there like they had something going on and they wanted to know if I could email them privately and talk to them. And I just was like, their last name was bogus. Like the whole thing seemed weird. I deleted the message because I'm just like,
it probably was some kind of stalking. Now you know, in places that we are celebrities, so you have people that will Facebook you, Instagram you, tweet you, and then you know
that could be someone who is not a friend of yours that want to have a peek into your life So they may create a page so if you befriend them and things like that, they can have that little sneak peek into your life.
Yeah,
I've had those, you know, friend requests, and they only have like one friend in common, and you're like, well, who are you? You know, like, right. This has got to be catfish, definitely.
Yeah.
Right. Speaking of the word catfish, what word did we use before we used the word catfish? You know how these slogans come out, and what did we use?
You just got.
Oh, and look, and before that, you just was bamboozled.
Yeah, you got bamboozled.
Like, before that, she ran amok on you.
The whole catfish thing is so funny to me. Like, we could have did this, everything that they're doing nowadays, you think about, I could have done that.
Right.
Like, especially 15 and pregnant, because we had that going on a long time ago. Yeah. And them girls made money.
Well, yeah. So... Well, reality TV has kind of taken over in the last 10
over
years.
The world,
so
period.
Right now, reality TV wants to step into everybody's life.
Because everybody wants a piece of being famous. And it's not so, you know, it was so easy for everybody to go into some of our sister stations and just demand a role on the soap operas. You know, so now with reality TV, it's giving people the opportunity for you to just be yourself, collect a wealthy paycheck if you're willing to disclose a lot of your daily routine.
Right.
You know, but it's, you know, social media, YouTube and all that is giving everybody a chance now to be their own celebrity. So
yeah.
YouTube is the reason I got this show started.
But for real, you be on the internet with YouTube. Like 60,000 followers and like 12 likes, and then in public don't nobody know who you is. I hate the internet. Like,
yeah.
So it's like the internet, it's celebrities on the internet. I seen a post the other day, it's just like Instagram is like Monopoly. You're famous on here, but in real life, you're, you know what? And you meet a lot of people like that. And I'm not saying it like this, but those people attitudes suck.
Right.
Like you on the internet bullying people, talking about people. When you see them in person, they like this.
Mm-hmm.
They're walking past you, but you're like, that's that person that's on the internet.
Well, we have a lot of locals here.
A lot of people do that.
We have a lot of local celebrities here that do a lot of internet bullying. I don't want to call anybody names.
Let's talk about bullying, period.
Yeah,
we
need to stop
that.
I don't want to call anybody names, but we have a lot of Facebook and internet thugs. And we have a lot of people in this good old town that we call Richmond, Virginia, that people will put themselves on certain pedestals and nobody else even knows who the hell they are.
It's going beyond that. We've talked about it a show before about bullying in the workplace. It's going everywhere.
Right.
I mean, NFL, you know, you were speaking some about that. And
I produced it, Frank D. was refreshing the week or whatever. The NFL has a situation going on with two players from the Dolphins, the Miami Dolphins.
Mm-hmm.
One of the guys came out, I think he's like a first-year player. And then you got a veteran on the team who's been picking with him.
Mm-hmm.
So they going back and forth with it. But I heard a sad conversation today. They was like, how this big man hollering, he getting bullied. Man, some of the biggest people are the ones that get bullied. Because they big, like they be soft. They be like teddy bears.
And it's not even about soft either. It could be money and power.
Just intimidating.
I'm just saying regular life.
Right.
Period.
Definitely.
At any middle school and high school, you got big kids who are getting bullied.
Right.
Right.
So it's just like, man, you can't say, oh, he this big, he shouldn't be talking about he getting bullied. Bullying is bullying.
Mm-hmm.
And then I really like what the schools are doing as far as these kids have a competition. Kimashawn, you know, from around that way, her daughter or son, one of her kids won the bullying contest. I seen her post it on Instagram. And they had to create some type of poster. But she said her daughter or son, I'm not sure which one, won first place.
Awesome.
Then my friend Anita, I seen last night, her son was doing a shirt with Keep Calm and Stop Bullying. I love it. He did it with a marker.
Nice.
It was dope.
We need a movement like that.
Yes,
and
that's that bullying.
We definitely need that movement with the children.
With the children, yeah.
You know, we sit up here, and I'm going to brag about this, is because this platform is something. So we need to encourage our young folks to get into things like that.
Right.
Yeah.
That is wonderful that the kids see that bullying can take a toll on it. Now,
because bullying used to be cool.
Right.
It used to give you some type of power because you felt like, I can bully this person.
I
can talk about this person.
Right.
I mean, I remember several times when I was young, I used to wear glasses. You remember that?
Yeah.
So my oldest brother was the one who put it into that. You talk about my sister, we got a problem. You know
right.
what I'm saying?
Right.
So, If you don't have nobody to protect you, you really alone.
We spoke on the last when the show when it was he and I. We talked about bullying. And the fact that we admitted that we were bullies in school.
Yes. And listen.
And listen. And I had to admit that I assumed being a bully because I had been taken advantage of as a child. Mm-hmm. Not by any other children, but bullying is a learned behavior. Mm-hmm. And I had been bullied or taken advantage of by certain people and I had assumed once I got a certain age, I assumed that I was going to attack you before you attack me attitude. And I inflicted that not only on kids, but on adults and people that had my best interests in heart. I just didn't want to see any eye to eye with them. I just had in my mind, I wasn't going to be a victim anymore. And I assumed that, and I apologize for being that, but it was definitely
but we
a learn.
But no,
but it was. Well, I'm not.
Well,
I'm
I
not,
didn't get a chance.
So
I
that's
apologize.
My statement. So don't tell me not to. I'm not re-apologizing about it. But I was saying, I was telling her that's what true. We was talking about, okay. And that I wasn't re-apologizing.
I
about
am apologizing.
But if I was re-apologizing, then that's on me. But it was a learned behavior. It wasn't I was just trying to be mean and cruel. It was.
Yeah, but look, I'm gonna tell you something
behavior.
That's crazy. I used to pick on two particular people, right? And like a couple of years ago, I found out they was my cousin.
That's happened to me.
Hey, no, for real. No. And I have happened. Never
thank
said
God
anything
the
to my
Lee
mom
family
about
has
it.
Always kept their kids under wraps.
No, man, I'm telling you, my family is so huge. My great grandma had 22 kids. So
wow,
believe it
impressive.
Or not, I would never know who's some kin to me. And I heard a lot of people saying, Nelly, my cousin, Chanel, my cousin, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But so many different names and this person from here
and
there.
And people married.
But it took for like someone to pass away. And then I see him, or then right. I, and then they're like, "Mom, I'm like, you know, that's your cousin." I'm like, "Oh shit."
Yeah.
But anyway, let's stop the bullying. Like, put that in your kid's head. Like, everything they have is a privilege that can be taken away from you and your family in the blink of my eye.
Right.
So just because you have something today is not promised tomorrow. And I guess if we explain that more to our kids, mm-hmm. they wouldn't do a lot of bullying.
Exactly.
And we want to say shout out to Kimashawn Briggs. I'm going to call her name out because
I wonder if she watches. If not spread the word.
If
to
your
somebody.
Child won a
bullying
contest,
the
bullying then
contest.
We want to give big ups to you because we feel like you are doing something right
but
as a parent.
Home.
Am I right, co-host?
Right.
All right. I want to say shout out to ladies and gentlemen on this Saturday, which is November the 9th. I want to get into this before we get to the show because we're going to get to everything after I do this. The Feed the Homeless Helping Hands is giving a Feed the Homeless from 10 to 3 at Monroe Park. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask for your support in this event. You can bring perishable items, non-perishable items. You can drop off sodas, waters, paper plates, napkins, tablecloths, anything of the sort that you feel will help the homeless out. We will be out there feeding them for approximately 5 hours.
Ooh,
if
I'm
you
there.
Guys want to come out,
well.
Yes, on this Saturday, November the 9th, from 10 to 3. If you want to contact Tony Sutton on Facebook, you can. If you want to actually drop donations off to me, you can at Charmette's at 204 North 4th Street. And I want to say, once again, this is our season finale, so let's turn up. What we got to talk about?
Well, we're getting all shout-outs and everything. I got to say something before we get deeper to our convo. We got almost 50 minutes left, so whatever. I just want to say happy early birthday to my mother. I know she's watching. Her birthday is Monday. Happy birthday, Mom. I love you. My nephew's birthday is Sunday. Marquis, happy early birthday to you, too. Scorpios rule for real. I never paid attention as to how many Scorpios I love.
Aww.
My girl Rock birthday next Friday the 15th. My homegirl Rock or whatever. So, yeah. So I just want to say happy birthday to all the Scorpions out there, whatever. And that's pretty much it. What about you, Sharon?
Well, I don't really like to do too many shout-outs, but I just would like
shout
to,
out to Born Fresh.
I just like to thank my husband and my two boys for being so supportive for me and anything that I do. And
three boys, because I'm up here, too. Hold on. And
learn something about him, too. He never wants to be left out of anything. Mario just got to, Mario, I love you, but I'm learning.
What do you mean I don't want to be left out?
No, I'm saying far as, just now.
I'm not going to be, when it comes to Shamir Miles, I'm not going to be left out with anything.
That's my first husband.
Right.
That's your first husband.
Yes. So
how are you today?
No!
I mean, the phone ringing. That's early, too.
Thank you for calling the Cutting Edge.
Hey, this is Kimashawn. I was calling about the about the shout-out that y'all gave to my daughter for that bullying.
Okay.
That's what's up, Kimashawn. I know I had seen it on your page, man. Congratulations with that.
much, Shaletta. That was real nice. You always, you had let me know you was gonna do it, so I could record it.
I ain't know. I like we just got in the mood of it.
So did somebody call you and tell you we gave you a shout out?
Like four different people just
shout out to our viewers in the Cap City. Yeah, thank you for calling, Kim Rashawn.
That's what's up.
So where do I get to see it again? Because I want to see it.
Well, you'll see it. We'll post everything on YouTube. Make sure you tune in. If you want to check out our page on YouTube, and thank you for calling, you can check out our page on YouTube. That's MOTHABALDWYN, all one word. Don't forget, like our page, subscribe to our page. You can catch up on all our past seasons right there.
Yeah, starting from the bottom. I told you, I watched those. I was like, I don't watch them. It was really starting from the bottom.
I'm
on everything. So you know me.
I'm so mad. It took her four seasons. She's been here for two seasons.
You just watched it. You've been here for two seasons and you just watched past seasons of the show you're on. He gave me the wrong link, if y'all want to know.
Right.
A whole season ago.
It was the wrong link. Anyway, I watched it.
She's busy. I love it.
So, what celebrity news we got going on? What's going on with the celebrities this week? Do we have any celebrity news that's popping off this week? Any Chris and Bruce news?
I don't really have much going on. I know Chris had a birthday party. Bruce, he was away in some kind of tournament with his other sons and stuff
She had
a beautiful birthday party. And you know, Kim's proposal to Kanye West was epic and stuff like that.
Did y'all hear that Kanye West gonna walk down the aisle? Like the husband be waiting on the bride. He wants her to wait on him. I bet, because he's a diva.
He's a diva. He just does everything. He wants to do everything on his own. He wants to be the only one.
He wants to be on his own.
It's just some people that just want to be outside the box so much.
Kanye always don't want to be left out. He want to walk down the aisle.
He want her to be waiting on him. What y'all think about that?
It sucks.
Something wrong with his brain.
Morally, he's
something's wrong.
And I wish Donda West was still here to slap him around a few times, because he is crazy. Did y'all hear that he gave Kim Kardashian the same ring as his ex-fiance?
No, I didn't hear that. You can check out
92.1. They have the same rings on. They got the same ring from her hand onto his hand.
Well, who was he engaged to? Some girl. He had, you know, they all share. Supposedly he gave them the same ring.
I guess he said, waste not, want not. You know?
Yeah. Something bald, something blue.
And her ex-husband for 72 days, Chris Humphries, he sold her ring for like some money. He had that junk on eBay. He came up with a bunch of settlement too.
Yeah. Wow. He kind of probably like went from rags to riches quick.
Yeah,
but what did he do before she messed with him? Did he do some kind of basketball? Yeah.
He's still actively playing. He plays for the Brooklyn Nets.
Oh, okay.
He's an active basketball player. He's been playing. He's not a superstar, but he was getting paid. You know, on the bench, he's a star now.
He's not a superstar, he's a paid star.
Yeah, he's a paid star.
And I'm quite sure if he tell a few stories behind the Kardashian.
Alexis is her name. His ex. My mom texted that.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Shout out to mama. I love her. She knows more than we know.
And we sitting up here.
Okay.
We gotta get her here to guest co-host. Do you remember last season? Last season when I co-host,
we talked about female women in combat.
Mm-hmm.
Well, today, breaking news, they had the first female statue unveiled at Fort Lee. In honor of our female women that serve our forces and stuff.
That's so awesome. I think that was really nice of them to do that.
And it's the first one. And you would think it should be a couple of them, but it's the first one. I'm glad
we
it's
gotta
here
get, we gotta
in Virginia.
Get
to, but that's awesome.
We're going to get to where we need to be at.
You know, Virginia, it's a slow
grind with everything.
It's a slow grind with everything in Virginia. It's a slow hustle. It's like people gonna support you if they like you sometimes. So
it depends on how they feel.
Yeah, it depends on how they feel. So sometimes it's like a weigh your options thing. You pull up to somebody with gloves and they might buy them, or they might not today, or they might buy them tomorrow.
Yeah, and it's so much of a city ass. They do it, I'm gonna do it too.
Right.
If, they, if I see one person supporting you, then I'm gonna just do it because they did it.
Just like your show.
There
a lot
go.
Of people see
Four
me
people
do it.
People called Kim and Sean. That was crazy. That's what's
right.
up, man.
That's good.
That's good. That's
shout out to the Cap City. One thing I always say is I love my city. And I'm not going to stop loving my city just because everybody else hate my city. Yeah. Maybe I think if you didn't like the city so much, you should pack up and leave.
Yeah. I mean, I want to pack up and leave. It's not that I don't, not because I don't love the city, but we got to expand out. So we got to spread ourselves all over the world.
Well, you can also expand yourself and live here, too.
Yeah, I think once you live somewhere and you learn the state and you learn your surroundings, it becomes
your home
redundant.
Too.
It becomes, it's boring. It's time you want to go somewhere else.
Okay.
I'm sure there's people that's in California that's like, I just want to turn down some nights. You know, it's just not always party. Right. It's not always what you see on TV. You know, we have a poor neighborhood too. We have homelessness. We have rural areas. It's not always what we see on TV.
California.
When we see a lot of these reality shows and we see them in Atlanta, all we see is that beautiful highway leading into Atlanta.
They have money.
But we also know that they face the same challenges and issues that we face here. And there's some people that is there, it's like
and
it
one
becomes
thing I
boring.
Can say that's not so watered down is Atlanta's television. Atlanta is actually that beautiful. California is not.
What you mean?
Atlanta, I don't know, because I've been to California. It was awesome.
The way, the scenery. You can ride
where
down
you go.
Peachtree, and
you
can see
you
a beautiful scene.
Do you know
six
how big California
miles.
Is?
I'm speaking on downtown Los Angeles.
It depends
like
on where
Hollywood
you go.
Hollywood and stuff like that. People get television and
but you got peach trees and palm trees.
Right. So it's definitely a total. It's a difference, but I think
you can see a difference, definitely.
Yeah, I think Atlanta and California's television is so like different when it comes to being authentic. Mm-hmm. Because I feel like Atlanta, the scenes that they show, and I've been there numerous times,
It's more black reality TV shows in Atlanta than there are in Hollywood. They're more white sitcoms.
Hey, I wish I was in Atlanta.
I wish I was just on one of the sitcoms.
I wish I was. Sometimes.
So do you wish you lived there?
Atlanta. Mm-hmm. No, I would definitely don't want to live in Atlanta. Oh. I thought I did, but I just realized I don't want to live. After this, I don't want to live there. After this little thing, right?
Oh.
No,
I'm just
joking.
No, but I love Atlanta. I wouldn't want to
live there. I want to live in, like, North Carolina, Charlotte or something. Like,
I'd rather live out there. It's not good to be able to have the outside life, but when you come home,
it's just home.
You just want to be
I'm
home.
That type of
you
home.
Know,
my subdivision.
Yeah.
I want to pull in my garage and let my door down and go into my home like I'm used to.
Do do.
And
say, hey, welcome home. Kick your feet up. All right, so we got this celebrity little talk. I really don't. I think we're getting rid of that next season. I don't really care about them. They don't do anything for me. Celebrity.
I just think fine and fun.
I'm anti-celebrity. You like it?
I like it.
Can talk about it, and I'm going to wear a shirt to say anti-celebrity.
That's awesome.
And when we interview them on our show, then
I'm just joking.
you make sure you wear that shirt, too.
No, I think that would be awesome. Because we have
everybody's here for their own views.
Yeah.
I
enjoy the whole Kim thing. I really do. Do you think Kanye's crazy?
I think Kanye is kind of, he's a sissy.
And
I'm not
going
to say he's crazy. I'm going to say he's just,
I think he's
unstable. He's mentally unstable.
And people are not paying attention to that. He took the Confederate flag and said that this is Kanye's flag. He has it on the
I think he's like a kid that just, you know, you tell him stuff is wrong and they just defy it.
Mm-hmm.
He knows that I'm Kanye. Who's going to check me? You
know,
that's what
somebody mama would have said.
So it's just a thing of power. You know, I'm who I am and I can do what I want to do and I can affect people in a certain kind of way.
Well, before I was like, you got any local news that you guys want to talk about?
Local news. You know what? You guys can, don't forget, I'm taking a bus trip to Atlanta. Contact me February 22nd through the 24th.
It's the local news. I was watching the news. Did you hear about they had two gun scares? I think it was 2 weeks ago. At Dinwiddie High School, and parents was just being notified about it today. 2 weeks later.
And that's what my mom said. She said, talk about the gun
two
stuff, the gun
weeks
scares,
later.
And the teachers, and the parents that burnt the little girl on fire. It's just a lot going on.
It's a lot going on.
Well, you know
what's wrong with the world?
what's wrong with the world is the world need to get in touch with themselves. The whole gun violence thing, what I think has come apart is people don't fight anymore. And don't get me wrong, I'm not with violence. I'm not for violence. Mm-hmm. But I feel like people has taken a point where they feel like, I'm going to shoot you. I'm not fighting. I don't feel like all that drama. But they don't realize a gun is more drama than having a fist fight in the neighborhood with your neighbors and going to your house and having a peaceful night. You understand what I'm saying? Back in the day, people fought. They fought. They went home. You still might have seen the same person and commute. Y'all
I think it's too. Because it's so easy to have access right. to a gun. Mm-hmm. And they're talking about screening people, and if you had like mental illness, you shouldn't have a gun, and screening people that have previous criminal histories. Okay, you don't have a criminal history until you commit an act with a gun. So therefore, you're right. missing out on a lot of people that have not already committed a criminal act right. with a gun by giving them one. I'm a person who think if you make the bullets cost more than the actual weapon,
people
will be mindful of where the 4th of July shooting. You're not going to be out there shooting on 4th of July if you have $3,000 bullets. No, yeah. You'll be out there with a BB gun, and you'll probably be more cautious of where you shoot your BBs
right.
at.
Right.
You know, you just have reckless people with these guns not being trained on gun safety.
Because I don't feel like guns should be taken away from people. I feel like as an American citizen, that is
you
something.
You do have the right to bear arms.
You should have that right to bear arms. Those are one of the rights that they gave us when they first made rights to bear arms. I mean, everybody had a pocket gun in your shack. You know, wherever you came from. I mean, I'm not opposed to guns. I just think guns are put in the wrong hands at the wrong time.
Sometimes, yeah.
Yes.
I mean, I honestly miss seeing a good fight. And not to say, like, I'm encouraging people to fight. But I feel like if there's going to be an agreement and you got to go get a gun, I hate it so bad.
Right.
Like, and then in that sense, in that mind, you really don't know who you're going to hit. It's no, right. But they don't have a name on it. It's the oldest saying, but it's so true. Mm-hmm. So many innocent lives have been taken away because you just shoot.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? With a one-on-one fight,
you're scared to go to events thinking, are they going to get the shooting?
Let me tell you something. These clubs have so many bad names because so many people are getting hurt at these clubs. They're getting killed outside the club. So when you think about a certain club, you don't want to go.
Right.
It's like so much drama.
And that's why they want to shut us all down.
We can't never have a nightlife here.
They don't want to give us nothing.
Nothing at all because it's the gun violence. It's crazy.
It's the small-minded individuals that feel like there's no way out or they don't have anything going on for themselves and lives.
Right.
People that has something going on is not just out there shoot them up, bang, bang. Right. You know, it's no way if you got into a disagreement with somebody out on the street that we going to
and
my think, trunk and you going to gun
and
them
I
down.
I think that some people, you know, some people have family members or close people that are akin to them that they know are these type of people.
I mean,
and we can sit around and, you know, when they come around, glorify, oh, that's my cousin, boo-boo, that's my nephew, that's
crazy.
So-and-so. Yeah, and he's crazy and things like that.
It.
But instead of us grabbing our youth or our little cousins and nephews, get that call, telling them, the way you're headed is wrong, you know, you're on the right, you're the wrong path, we don't do that.
Thank you for calling the Cutting Edge.
Yeah, so I'd like to make a comment on the guns.
Yes.
First of all, I want to shout out to the Cutting Edge.
Thank you.
I'm sure going to miss you guys on Thursday because that was my main thing to look at. But I want to make a comment on the gun violence. It's just that the world is just so crazy now that, you know, these innocent people, we are so afraid. We go to the stores and things happen. You go shopping and things happen. Mm-hmm. So sometimes guns can be good and bad.
Mm-hmm.
Because these people are rolling up on you like it's nobody's business.
Yeah.
And so we have to protect ourselves because we cannot keep on being the victim.
Right.
You know, so, you know, like I say, shout out again to you guys, and I wish y'all very much success.
Watch us in January.
Yes, watch us in January. Make sure you look out for us. And don't forget to like our page on Facebook if you haven't already. Thank you for calling.
I was sharing a story. Well, let me get back to it. My mom told me, a friend of mine is almost like a brother. He got killed last year. And I put a saying on the back of my shirt. It said, think twice before you take a life. And I wore the shirt to work, and like so many people was like, oh, that's a nice thing. I mean, it said, you know, you got something on the front of your shirt, right. But the saying on the back is tough. And I'm like, it is. Like, if people would just think, like you said, twice, mm-hmm. because you got people that's locked up who had futures.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But you know what? At that time when you drinking, mm-hmm. and the time when you trying to be the man or that girl, mm-hmm. you ain't really thinking about right. that. You just mm-hmm. thinking about that pistol you got yes. in the car. Because I've been, I done had many days. But, you know, I think about a lot of stuff that's like, you know, I guess everybody think on their own, but mm-hmm. you, people tempt you so much.
People will tempt you. Let me tell you.
And you can't really blame a lot of people, but a lot of stuff don't make sense. But a lot right. of stuff you just like, eh. Mm-hmm. That's why I'm always quiet.
A lot of
quiet
stuff could be avoided.
I got a lot of people on this side. I got a lot of people on that side. Mm-hmm. So I'm mutual. I'm quiet. You know what I'm saying? Oh, but
it's
because when you from where we from, you know. You really don't.
You used to
a lot of stuff.
Popping
but
off.
Like, yeah,
but it's
so
somehow
like,
me having an 8-year-old son, I have to teach him now that defending yourself just isn't defending yourself.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Sometimes
defending yourself
away.
Could wind me, land me into a lawsuit.
Mm-hmm.
Just by you defending yourself because
you
someone
have a big
hurt you.
8-year-old son.
Yeah, you know, it doesn't even matter if he was smaller one. It doesn't even matter if he's a smaller one. You know, a child, you know, they're wrestling around in school. A child falls and hurt themselves or something. Injures themselves. I have a lawsuit mm-hmm. because this child now needed stitches or something like that. Ooh. Or you have, you know, like you said, if he is a bigger child and someone was being aggressive to him and he lashed out and hurt them, then he's not, you know, protecting himself.
Yeah, no, but when you think
it's
about
like,
the kids.
It's just something.
But think about your son being an innocent, good boy, quiet, man, his own.
And
another boy come on to him. Your son knock him out. Lawsuit,
yes, and then
right
I had to tell sometimes
like
to just walk away because
yeah,
me being a parent, my worst fear was what I've had some of my girlfriends or women in my life to experience getting that phone call about something happening to your son or your son being the person that has done something. That would be my worst fear. So I have to tell my son, you just have to walk away.
Walk away.
Matter of fact, run.
Thank you for calling the Cutting Edge.
Now run.
Run.
Oh, King Mario and Queen Shamia. Well, how are y'all doing?
Hey there.
Well, how are you?
This is Brandy Mario.
Hey,
how you doing, Queen Lafayette? Shout out to
I am just so blessed and humbled by this whole show.
Yeah.
You know, God is good, and it's only the grace that can stop you from busting somebody upside the head out here these days, like for real.
Yes.
You know, it is definitely, you know, we all got the right to bear arms. But when the guns don't work, then you go to the hands. You feel me?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You know, and I just want to give a nice shout-out to this little guy. He lost his life, Jeremy. Like, that's my friend Dorel's son.
Mm-hmm.
And his father is incarcerated, and they won't let him out to attend the funeral. And, you know, it's just, this baby was like 20-some years old. You know what I'm saying?
Was he 21? Did it happen over Southside?
Yeah, it did.
That's what happened over Southside the other day.
Yeah.
I know so many people.
I just thank God for
that.
Y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much.
Thank you,
hey,
too.
Hey, one second, real quick. Ladies and gentlemen, this person who we got on the phone, I want you to go out, and I want you to tell them right now what is the name of your book so these people can go pick it up, please.
My book is called Girl, Don't You Know You a Queen.
All right. So shout out to Brandy, you guys. And if you guys want to check her out, you can hit me up on Facebook and I will lead you into the right direction. Once again, thank you for calling again and check out her book. What she said was, Girl,
You Know You a Queen.
Yes, I'm so not good with that stuff. I have so much stuff in my head, but she knows I love her. So if you want to check out and you want to read her book, please pick it up.
That's crazy.
Or contact me on Facebook.
Because I follow his cousin and she had wrote something. I'm like, I'm for real. I'm gonna tell you, I'm a sensitive person. I'm a counselor, and I'm very sensitive.
Mm-hmm.
And when I was reading it, and I had tears in my eyes because she was like, it was his homeboy. He had been with the guy all day. I don't know if these are facts. It came from someone, and I seen it just to see that much of it.
That just made my stomach hurt.
Yeah, like it just put me in a whole different place. But I was like, you know what, I'm going to just say my peace and my prayer for them and try to keep scrolling. Mm-hmm. The internet will break you down when you see all this stuff that's going on. And then when it hits you close to home,
mm-hmm.
like, I almost lost my brother. My oldest brother's in a wheelchair.
Mm-hmm.
My brother got shot 2009. He's paralyzed from the waist down.
Mm-hmm.
I thank God for him every day, but my brother has struggled with it so much. Like,
right.
people don't understand that the mental, the minds, and the state being the people that's like that, you got to try to deal. It does. And I have loved him from a distance for the last 2 months. It hurts me a lot, but you got to let people grow into the reality of things, into the situation. You know I love him. Yeah. And everybody knows I love my brother. Mm-hmm. You know, no matter what he said, what he put out there on the internet, I love him. He loves me.
Yeah.
But in situations like this, as a human being, you have to, like, humble yourself. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because at any rate, I could have lost my brother.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Life could be so different from me.
Mm-hmm. He got a baby.
He got a daughter. He was an angel. Janaya, my niece. I love you, baby. That's
so great. I see her often, too.
Oh, I love my niece. She's been there. But anyway, I love her. But that situation was very sad. Mm-hmm. 21 years
it was
old.
Sad.
And then weeks prior to that, a week prior, it was a boy named Rodney. That got, y'all seen the school bus accident with a Jeep?
Yes, in Verona.
He was in the military. Mm. He had played football for Verona, a good boy.
He swerved off the road and hit that bus.
I think a lot of that is just
things happen for a reason.
Right.
And even though if it's not directly affecting you, I think it's all meant for all of us to hear it.
To see it. Mm-hmm.
You know, because it's funny how I believe I know this young man's father from just years ago in the church or community. But I work with somebody who was some kin to them. And it just somehow it made it a full circle, and it brings it close to home to you. It's not my person, you know, in my family, but I feel the sense of that's a reality check for myself. Mm-hmm. You know, you don't never know when and how, you know, when the time is up, and life is just so priceless.
Yeah. And
so
someone,
did we ever find out what happened? Like, why did he swerve in front of that bus?
I don't know. I've heard different situations,
call?
But I really
don't
know.
I've heard a few things. I just want to know that we have the actual call.
You know, you never know the facts. And like earlier, I lost my little cousin, Bam Bam. That Monday, prior to him losing his life, he was going to the Navy. And somebody, an older guy killed. It's like these older people are taking away these younger people. They're not letting them live.
And it's
happening too much. The older guys are killing these younger guys, either one over jealousy, two, they have an issue within themselves, and they see these younger boys either doing something with their self or doing something better, and they're taking that anger out and killing them. Mm-hmm. And that's pussy all day.
Right.
We all
right.
know that.
Right.
And it's so hurtful. Like, what do you do? You can't really do nothing. You know, like me, I'm numb. Like, so many people that passed away, it's like I don't even really even know how to go and comfort people no more. Like, I know how I feel in my heart, but it's like it's consistent.
Right.
It's
feeling numb where you feel like you
it's
have
crazy.
To console people.
It's crazy.
Just see people go through tragedy and you know, you're right.
It's crazy.
Thank you for calling the Cutting Edge.
Yes, you know, I have a comment as well. I think that before we do anything, we really need to teach our children about Jesus. He is the covering. I have two sons. I have a 17-year-old and a 14-year-old. And for one, they black. And for two, they men. So that's two strikes against them already. And I just feel different when they leave out the door opposed to when my daughter leaves out the door. You know what I mean? And it just takes a lot for me to just humble myself and just put them under the grace of God and just know that God, take care of my babies when they leave out here because it ain't even safe to go to school no more. I mean, the problems that these kids really are dealing with, this ain't stuff we dealt with y'all when we was younger. I mean, you send your baby out, that may be the last time you see your baby. Because a kid at school shot your baby. Like, you know what I'm saying? As a mother, what you supposed to do? You supposed to grieve? Or is you supposed to get looked at in the got you pay? You feel me?
I feel you.
Thank you for calling.
You know, that was my comment. This Brandy again. That was my comment. My other thing was a shout out.
Thank you, Brandy.
You know I love y'all. Y'all have a blessed one.
You too.
Thanks for calling once again. You guys can pick her book up. I don't know if you guys have heard of it, but the name of the book is Girl.
You know you're a queen.
You know you're a queen. Yeah.
I love that. I'm all for that. I love it.
Make sure you pick the book up now.
Yes.
Hey, now I'm going to tell y'all something wrong.
I'm going to miss y'all.
I'm going to miss you too.
Oh my God. I'm so like bad right now, but I'm okay.
It's like a rant.
I know.
But we gotta come back.
So what are you gonna tell us? Give us some breaking news you got for us right here.
I mean, it's not really breaking news. I know we've been everywhere. We're trying to get everything in, but I basically wanted to touch bases on women and children and women actually doing good backgrounds on the men that they're deciding to deal with or the women, because this family was killed last week. This lady was a nurse. Go ahead.
Thank you for calling The Cutting Edge.
Hello.
Thank you for calling The Cutting Edge. Can you turn your TV down, please?
Oh, no problem. Yeah, I'm listening to you guys, and you guys are having a very interesting conversation.
Okay,
But my thing is, and my question to you guys is, with all what's happening, who would you all blame? Because I think it's the system is causing all of this. Because for one, if you look at it nowadays, kids, parents cannot scold kids anymore, because it becomes you are abusing kids if you scold them. And those are the things that cause the kids to go out and do the things that they are doing. Because what happened is that we have too much bureaucracy in our bedrooms. Mm-hmm. You understand? So, I mean, until we can get stuff like those addressed,
right. Then
it will not be better.
Okay. So, Thank you so much for calling.
I think definitely there's some of our systems that are in place. Spare the rod, spoil the child. Mm-hmm. It's definitely some of our system in places that do not support us as parents. Mm-hmm. I'm an advocate for trying to change things like CPS, the way they operate. Mm-hmm. Instead of CPS, when I think of CPS, I think now that they're just going to come in, remove my kid, throw me in jail, don't give me any help.
Yes.
Child Protective Services should also have an extent, a part of their, where I can call in and say, I'm just stressed as a parent.
Right.
I have a child who has been suspended 3 or 4 times. It is not my household. I run my household military. It is me and my husband. Our kids, you've been there. But when my son goes to a school that is laid back and he can show off, he is a kid. He's going to do only what they allow him to do.
Right.
So I fought a battle last year with the school was not supporting me and my husband as being a destructive household.
Right.
He would go to school and do things, and they would tell me, I'm like, are we talking about the same kid?
Right.
And I had to realize he's having fun.
Yeah.
He's at school. He's out of an uncontrolled environment. So
thank you for calling The Cutting Edge.
Okay, hello. I wanted to say one thing. You know when they told us that we as a parent, we supposed to do certain things? Okay, our kids are the parents, and we are the kids, because our parents have forgotten how to teach our children to be children, to be grown-ups.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we are sending our kids to school and letting the school teach the children instead of us teaching our kids before they go to school.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I've lost a brother. My younger brother, been dead 18 years, 4 people shot him, and they still don't have the people that shot him.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You have to look at what in today's society, what is going on. A lot has to do with our government. They letting it go, and not if you in one section of the town and not in the other section of the town, they don't care what's going on in one section, but they want to find out what's going on in the other section. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You know, I mean, it's not a black or white issue. It's about being people.
Right.
Learning to where you come from.
Right.
And I'd like to thank y'all for listening.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you for calling.
With everything we talking about tonight and then what he said, I honestly think that the world's just missing love. We don't really know how to love no more. We don't know how to simply take a generous
compassion.
Hug or you look nice or thank you. Everything is always, you know, people
but
always
telling me
like,
I look nice, fuck.
Yeah.
People are always feeling intimidated by you or your niceness or your happiness. But when you are a Christian and you are a person of God, that is how you're supposed to live. Mm-hmm. And I'm learning that, you know, my happiness should never destroy you.
Right.
And people don't know how to take that. They will try to destroy you because you're always happy.
Yeah.
And the world doesn't have enough love.
Thank you for calling the Cutting the Edge.
Yes, how y'all doing tonight?
We're doing good. How are you?
Sorry. I'm doing fine, sir. I'd like to call and comment on the gun control. It's not the guns that need to be controlled. It's the people that need to be controlled.
Right.
People need to be taught about life and its consequences. You got a lot of guys that run around thinking they're killers because they're carrying guns. They don't have no value for life.
Mm-hmm.
That's because they never been taught how valuable life is. Right. You know, that's a problem. And with the generation guy, with the older guys you have now, and they're mid-30s, as you have that 21, 22 now.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
They don't, there's a respect factor there.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And they don't want to listen to the older guy telling them how they're supposed to carry it out here in the world.
And
so the younger guys, you know, about them being so stubborn and hard-headed, man. That's the problem and that's the issue right there. Because mm-hmm. when I was growing up, I'm 36 years old. When I was growing up, you had older guys back in the early 90s and the late 80s. You know, they'll talk to the young guys mm-hmm. and tell them, look, man, you shouldn't be out here doing this or doing that, no matter what their occupation was. Right. If they was right. in the streets or they had a 9-to-5. Right. You know, now you can't do that with these young guys. They mm-hmm. don't want to listen because they're listening to these rap songs and learning how to sell drugs off the internet now. They learning how to carry guns from the internet now. You know what I'm saying? Listening to this music. You know, you just can't control it. They think they know everything. You know?
Right.
You know? Until it gets into the situation where these young guys are listening to these older guys that's trying to teach them about life and the value of life and its consequences,
right.
then it'll be all good.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you for calling,
sir. Thank you for calling.
All right, you're welcome.
I mean, that's by far. That's true. That's facts.
That's yeah. right.
A lot of people are hard-headed. I mean, a lot of young kids don't want right. to listen to anybody. Mm-hmm. They think mm-hmm. they know everything.
Mm-hmm.
If I could rewind about 10 years ago.
You don't want me to have fun. I mean, yeah, I want you to have fun, but I want you to have
really
safe fun.
Yeah, like yeah, all the fun. Kids. I guess.
But you know, I think we all guilty of our parents telling us,
don't do that.
And we just, she's just trying to ruin my fun and just don't want me to do nothing. And we've done it and we've been like, oh my gosh, they were exactly right. I have messed up.
I have a quick story real quick. Apparently, it was this nurse that was in the news for beating up this old elderly lady. Did you guys see that story?
No.
You didn't.
I saw it.
So, a nurse at the agency Care Advantage out there at Willow Lawn. And Care Advantage is supposed to be one of the biggest agencies.
They are
right
at home health care.
Yes, the biggest home health care.
They got her on the news.
She was on the news yesterday, and the lady was 80-some years old, but her nurse was 50-some years old. The lady who was getting beaten was an 80-some-year-old white woman, and the black woman was beating her up. They set up a nanny cam on her and got her beating their mama up.
And caught her.
Now, if this ain't one of them situations where I just wish that I was not black for one day on the news.
When I went into the nursing profession in like 1995, 96.
Mm-hmm.
And at that time, Virginia had a shortage of nurses. So a facility that I worked at paid us to go to school to become nurses, and you signed a contract and you worked there for a year and you didn't have to pay back your tuition. However, at that time, you had people that genuinely cared to take care of other people.
Right.
Now you have everybody and their auntie wanting to be a CNA or a personal care aide because they can wear a uniform. Yeah. And they can't take care of themselves or their kids, but you see them dressed up in a nurse's outfit,
mm-hmm.
and you're like, well, who parent are they taking care of?
Right.
And we know these people, mm-hmm. you know? And I'm like, I would not let her come in here and take care of my dog, but we see these, we talk to them, had a job going, girl.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so in my mind, I wonder, do I know this person?
I
know a lot of people that work through there.
And
that's a profession that you have to be in
for
your heart,
for
because no amount of pay, they could have gave me $50 an hour. It still was not enough to take care of a human life.
Right.
That's not a basket of french fries. That's someone's loved one. So you got people out there doing it just for a quick dollar, knowing they can get a job. And it's a shame. It's terrible.
Well, what I say to that is, I just want to say people need to, these agencies, and Care Advantage does, I don't want to call names, they do an extensive background. They do a drug test, they do a background check.
But like
check.
I said, they aren't a criminal until they commit an act. You might have this woman coming in, she's going to take care of your mom,
right.
And all of a sudden she had a bad day from last night, and then she's in there abusing her, and now she has a rec for abusing elderly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So what happened to when you took care of your grandma? You took care of your aunt. That cousin, he might was in that back room because he had physical challenges and he looked a little weird, and you kept him in the back room, but he stayed in that back room.
Yeah.
You might have had one or two of them that went to insane asylums and mental placement because they were just really unmanageable at home. But now we have so many healthcare agencies. We have so many healthcare agencies because so many people don't want to take care of their loved ones. Mm-hmm. They just don't want to do it.
And I'm not saying it as bad. I feel like with today, in reference to that comment, people has put a strain on people. It's just like moms. Moms can't even fully take care of their kids in a 24-hour span without having to go to work 12 hours.
Tell me
you
about
know,
it.
Without yeah. having to do certain motherly duties require you to take away from the children.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not, like we said,
wait, I got this thing in my phone.
The environment, the whole way that we're living, I feel like everything is just taking a toll on us, where everything is just becoming so quick and so fast,
and we aging so fast.
Right, and things are just taking a turn for the worse. I'm not going to bring God or Jesus in this whole situation is because I felt like that's just something that we're not gonna, you know.
I need that on a t-shirt.
It
read
says
that out loud.
One person who does the work of 20 for free.
Right.
No check.
No
benefits.
Like,
no, I don't have any benefits.
True.
I don't get any sick days. Yeah. No vacation time.
You know, I have no days off when you
could be sick.
No
your children still going to say, Mom, I need breakfast. You could have the flu with a robe on. Children don't know anything about how sick you are. All they know is they are home. They are hungry.
Yes.
I just want to say, one thing I want to say pertaining back to that conversation back then, I do think we need to go back into the old days. I think we need to find a way where we can get this government to get this whole child abuse lift thing. I feel like these children don't need to be beat, but I feel like they need to be scared.
They need to be disciplined. I need to be able to discipline my child. I need to be able to discipline my child
in
Walmart. If I so choose to, and no one jump out, if you are showing off in Walmart, I should be able to snatch you around. Even if I want to take you in the bathroom and, you know, do what I need to do, you know, as long as, you know, we know the difference from
abuse
and things, but it's been a fine line where some people have claimed abuse, so sometimes we don't know whether to believe
it
or not, but
I'm going to say this too, though. A lot of parents need to get a bond with their children. And maybe if you have your children respect and love you so enough that they won't disrespect you or misbehave, you wouldn't have an issue, because I could get one look from my mama back in the day and I'll sit down.
But let me tell you.
You know what I'm saying? Her eyes are getting red now. I used to be like,
I used to see those kids in the grocery store and be like, what is that lady doing? I have one of those kids now. He's two.
He's like, okay.
Let me tell you, I have one of those kids now. I don't know how I wound up with one, but I was always a judgment of person because I can control a kid with
a
knife.
Let me tell you,
I can control. Look, and he know I can control a kid with the eye. Every one of my friends' kids, you know, I give them the eye and they know don't play with me. But I have this 2-year-old.
He's scared.
He give me the eye back. He give me the eye back.
I'm like, he gives me the eye back.
I'm like, you know,
it's not a finger.
He's not a disrespectful kid or anything like that. He's just a, you know, a little tickler and toddler.
You know, just
try
he's
you and,
pointer.
You know, want to touch you and, you know, talk back with the finger and stuff.
We just,
you know,
get the kids in a mingle of older, younger. They got to be around a lot of people. They got to have some type of personality and humor because, you know, it was the nanny, the cousin, and the great little cousins. We got to stop keeping our kids sheltered. That's why kids are bad. You think that might be one of this? You might be onto something.
Another thing that has changed is, like you said, we had the nanny, the mother, the uncle, the aunt, the everything. So what happens was, if I got in trouble, everybody in my family that who was an adult knew about it. Everybody that seen
me. So you think I should let him out a little bit more?
Yeah, because let me tell you, some parents don't want their kids to be out. But when you get them out there and you learn them, you'll see that personality, and then you'll be like, okay, this is what I need to work on with them. And somebody else can tell you, your son is really good at this, and you never knew it. Or your son is weak at this, you should do it up. You gotta, like, you know what I'm saying? I mean,
because I kind of have right now, because right like, now I try to keep them in the home.
What she's saying, and we say it all the time, it takes a village to raise a child. Yeah, and I totally respect everything and all those views. Thank you for calling The Cutting Edge.
Well, I personally think that a lot of times that back in the day when we was being raised, our parents found constructive things for us to do. I think a lot of TV programs that kids look at, they spend a whole lot of time looking at TV, teaches them a lot of things now. These little cartoon things that they look at now is off the hook.
Yeah, so, what happened to Mother May?
You know,
I ain't heard that in a minute.
Right. You bring your chair home, you sit them in front of TV for several hours, and they pick up a lot. Not, of
they got yeah, bugs. Bugs Bunny was spending credit card.
I just wanted to share that.
I was like, what?
Thank you. That's very true. Like, the technology and everything that's
thank
at home, kids don't go out. Like, you can sit right. over and observe kids. They like this all day. And then when you tell them something, what? You know what I'm saying? Like, you used to want to come home, run outside. I used to want to get my ball, go outside,
run outside,
right.
Play.
Right. But it's like, you want to be in the house. You want to be all up and grown.
On the internet.
Home. Like, what do you do?
And you know what we just were saying, and she said a valid point. We need parental control.
Right.
It is no way in the world that these people are setting all these things up for us.
Yeah.
And we don't have a way to control
it. Totally, yeah.
What she's saying about the cartoons and everything, I feel like all that is a valid point.
That's
but as a parent, you're supposed to have control over every aspect of your child's life, whether it's television, the rec team, like you said, you want your child sometimes
is,
to walk away.
Family Guy is
something
double.
Else.
Do y'all hurt me? Don't let
thank you
kids
for calling The Cutting Edge.
You know what else I have seen, too? It's a lot of, I want to say parents, they want to be their kids' friend.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Like, you know, my mom, she definitely didn't let me do whatever I wanted to do. But I was scared of my mom.
Yes.
You know, I knew that I couldn't just go ahead and, all right, I'm going to do this.
Mm-hmm.
You know, my mama throw a shoe at you. You hear me?
A shoe. I know that's right.
Like, you know, that just was basically what I wanted to comment on. Just the whole parent of it all. That's why it's a parent.
Okay.
Thank you
for calling so
look,
much.
Look, can I say something before we run out of time?
Mm-hmm.
You had mentioned that it was a good turnout for the election. And I wanted to mention that if you showed up to vote and you didn't have proper identification,
mm-hmm.
they went ahead and let you cast your vote.
Mm-hmm.
But they are giving you a week now to show back up and prove your proof of identity or your vote would not count.
Mm-hmm.
They have like 300 people from Henrico County, 70
oh,
people,
man.
70, 300 people. From Henrico County, 70 people from Richmond City. And like it's like other pockets of Virginia,
let's get back all
and
day,
the
get
race
together.
Is so tight that they
let's
need
that together.
These,
we don't
they
need
these votes.
Nowhere. Hello, I am a part of the
look,
Democrat
so
Party,
we,
and I approve
oh
this
my
message.
God.
We definitely don't need
the
that.
Show
so
does
go
not,
out and
the
show your stuff.
Yes.
Let me tell you something.
That
name hits opinion. Too close to my name. I don't like it. This is my opinion. I am not for Cuccinelli, and I approve this message. Please get out there and go and show them people your ID.
I'm an independent.
Hey, you see that? You're independent.
I'm not a Democrat or a Republican, and I'm just don't want to let my
just,
viewers
we
know.
Just want to say, hey, if you did not have your ID when you voted in this
election, you need a ride.
You need
to
go down
me.
And
you need a ride.
Show your
you
ID.
Need a ride to get back up. If you voted for Cuccinelli, I can't
can
help.
Can they still get a ride?
You can't get a ride for
that's
me.
Sad. These people are still Americans, so
people,
I feel like whoever you voted for, please get out there and take your ID.
If you
be anonymous, then if you need a ride, you voted for him.
Y'all have just chopped what I was trying to say up. I'm just saying,
I'm
if you
I'm
voted,
sorry.
That meant you wanted your vote to count, no matter
mm-hmm.
who you voted for.
Right.
I do not care. But I'm just saying, we want every vote to
you
count. And if you are not aware that they they're not going to count your vote. You need to get out there with your identification and prove who you are so it does count.
Let's get it. Let's get out, get back where you need to get to and go ahead and do that.
And that was great that now we see more people are being more aware and coming out. I love to see with numbers like that. I love that because now that make you know that people are listening to what's going on and being aware of what's going on. And once we become aware and educate, we can be able to change, make some things change, man. But we got to also understand that they can't do it alone.
Right.
We have to start change within our own homes, within our own communities, within our own states before we can even think about what they're going
to
do on that national level.
We got to
start it there.
And it starts with like the governor and the mayor. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful episode.
It's
been a wonderful season.
Yes.
And we want to say congratulations to our new co-host who has a wonderful voice and opinion here on The Cutting Edge.
Make sure y'all follow.
Follow us on Facebook
at Born Fresh and Pearl.
At RVA is The Cutting Edge. Make sure you like our page. Yes. Make sure you follow us. Make sure you support our movement. The Cutting Edge is on a move. We will be back next season for season 5. We will be revamped and we'll be back here with another co-host.
But we want y'all here. Like you got a story to tell. We would like to hear you. People here.
Thank you for joining us.
Show.
We like to say that please like our page and we want to see you guys next time. Thank you. This has been a wonderful season.
Awesome.
And we'll see you. Thank you guys for joining us.
I
want to
say thank y'all guys for having me on here. It's been a pleasure.
Oh, we love
you guys are awesome.
We love you. Shout out to the Cap City. Make sure you follow us on Facebook.